is to introduce two concepts and the relationship. One, business. Versus mathematics. What is the establishment of relationship between business and mathematics? In fact, it looks so obvious that you talk of business, you are talking about mathematics. Because for one, we know what business organizations are, those organizations where the production, the net profit matters, the income matters. And the only way you can measure income is to count. And the only way you can find counting is in mathematics. So you cannot go without mathematics. It's like they have a direct relationship. They are like synonyms. Yes, because actually mathematics evolved from the need to count, to quantify things. That's why one of our first topic we are going to look at is set theory. Set theory. Set theory is a fundamental building block of mathematics. And in fact, mathematical sciences. The whole mathematics evolved. In fact, we sometimes call it foundation mathematics, foundation of mathematics. So that's why you find set theory has a very diverse application. In fact, it's not only applicable to business studies, it's also very much applicable in social sciences. It is very much applicable in arts. It is so much applicable in designs. It is so much applicable in physical sciences, physics, chemistry, and so on and so forth. It is very widely applicable. Part of this application is in business studies. We shall come to see how and why. But at least we know for now that you cannot understand business without understanding your arithmetic skills, isn't it? Because the market woman has to be very good, at least in counting, isn't it? So even if you don't go through any formal education, at least one thing is certain, that once you are involved in any business where your aim is to attract gains or profits or to grow, you must have a good sense of count. You must know how to add, for example, how to subtract, how to partition, how to group, how to, all these are mathematical concepts. Even grouping of items in a particular shell into one corner is a theoretical concept, actually, isn't it? And then counting how many there are, and counting the units, knowing, finding the net volume, vis-a-vis the unit price. It's also a mathematical concept because you have to learn multiplication, isn't it? 10 tins of geisha or sardines, each one costing 2,000 nails. You have 10 times 2, which is 20,000 worth of sardines in your store. And even the market woman should be able to know this. So that the moment one goes off, she will know that she has lost one. So, just like business studies cannot do without mathematics, also we cannot study mathematics without set theory. And that's why it is one of the, it is our first topic. But what is set? that is possible. What do we call sins, first of all? Because you need to know the definition of a particular concept before you can begin to know what it is, what are its properties, what are its applications, and so on. So set. This one has varied definitions. For 1 million and one definitions, there are 1 million and one definitions of happiness. It's like everybody defines set in his own perception of the concept of set. But so long as that definition encapsulates the fundamentals of set, and that is grouping or collection, it is okay. It doesn't have to be a particular definition. Once it incorporates two things that will have a connection, objects, and second, that these collections is governed by some, let me say, some requirements or some rule, let me call it rule. Rule of association. I think once these two are encapsulated, you have a good definition of set. I don't want to say just a collection, but if you just say just a collection, it means you cannot distinguish between one collection and another. But if you involve the rule now, this rule will allow you to distinguish between one set and to different sets, isn't it? Because you have now a group of just somewhat like a belonging to a block. Each color will have its own group, isn't it? And it is whether or not you satisfy the requirement of those rules will guarantee or will testify or will show whether or not you are a member. Association of students, for example. We know we have very tight group titles. Harvester Student Association, Software Student Association, Chemistry Student Association, Zamborester Student Association. From the name, you know you have some bit of group that you have to be an indigene of those states to belong to those associations. It means if you are not an indigene of Kwara, you cannot belong to Kwara state, even if you are a student. So that means there is some sense of rule of association. And this rule is what determines what belongs to what. What set? If you have a group of students, like in this polytechnic, this rule identifies whether he belongs to Software Students, he belongs to KV, he belongs to Kwara, he belongs to Lagos, he belongs to all of this rule. So while you have elements scattered, you can use this rule to distinguish between a particular group. So there is a sense of function there, or functionality, a mapping, if you like, that which relates a B, where A is your collection and B is your set. There is some sense of mind, a function, which now specifies based on this. Yes. So that is the definition about, so we accept this can be our first definition. That sets our collection of objects, satisfying any collection satisfying, governed by some rule of association, any collection. So you can say, let me put it, any collection of objects. Governed by
So removal of this desire.
I am so for you who have my book, which I wrote on practical application of sentiment. I have said a lot on why I need this upon this rule in order to have a well-defined set. Because in theory you say well-defined.
Well,
it means if you don't have rule, you are not well-defined. You are just a student. Like, you are not well-defined. I think it's better we say you are a student or coming from self-trusted. Or was GPA. So these words are actually defining you and they are making you distinguish from the rest of the elements. Notations. The notation we shall use alpha case. They call them Greek letters, okay? It's in Greek. A, B, C, X, Y, to denote sex. And the lower case, symbols did not exist. Then you have another word which you have not in elements. What do you call elements? Why do you say elements?
You call it this the most.
or you say is a member of. So that means your resistance, we say AI is a member of E. It's how you read it. Say AI is a member of E. I ranging from 1 to 10. So this is how you write. This simple. Yeah, I and A. I equals 1, 2, ... means AI is a member of A. AI element is a member of A set for I ranging from 1 to 10. So these ones are called, it means columns. We call them elements. Now elements or members of set A. Okay. Now, as on the basis of this membership of this set, you are going to have types and types of sets depending on how these members are behaving. How they are enumerated. So you'll have other definitions then. Set in which there is not a single.
Business is about actually
achieving its own goal. Isn't it? Of course, every business actually is that. It's a group of people, group of resources, group of techniques will come together with a unified aim of achieving what? Profits. This is an organization as the main aim is for any other thing is vital. Just like public organizations, it's also it's about actually coming together to as a social organization. But a public render services. This is an organization is coming together for core services, but with the aim of achieving a network. In public organization, you don't need work. In public organization, no profit making. Our only construction of people, techniques, methods, resources with the aim of what? Dispensing services, social services. For governance, for example, we are all part of social services. The business will gather people, material, techniques, and so on with the problem of making products. So that when you start from one set of building you will achieve, you will take set a target in the next 10 years. I should have 3 or 4 business like this. Or I was starting with a capital, maybe 2 million euro. You are setting a target, maybe in 10 years' time, it should be worth 20 million. That is a goal. Since that is a goal, since in any business, once you say organization, once you say organization, then you have sense of right. You are talking about not just a single process or single collection. You are talking about multiplicity of collections. And because we are talking about multiplicity of collections, we cannot do without steps. Because each collection is going to form a different set, a unique set. Isn't it? Like an organization, we are going to have a set of managers, administration, maybe managerial section, MD, manager, commercial manager, sales manager, finance, and so on and so forth. They will construct themselves into one group, which they call managerial, what do we call them? But in the organogram, you will have them as a top. Isn't it? In the hierarchy of managerial, so you have the managerial staff as the top.
Session workers.
Decision makers. Decision makers, actually, you also call them decision makers. Like in social organizations. So you have a managerial team as one group. Each team of managerial of each person, each one among this team is going to control subgroups. For example, the marketing manager is going to construct maybe sales manager, airport manager, even finance, something like that, under sales, under him. And then any manager, a sales manager, for example, is going to have sales staff, users that are working, but that are going out to, for advertisement, promotions, and so on and so forth. Because you have to have policies. You have a brand in business organization, you don't keep producing just the same brands. You need to incorporate the promotion aspect. So that maybe in 5 years, you are going to mold it into another brand. By the time people get a bit used to it, you are selling lots, for example. You cannot keep selling lots for 20 years. Then you give yourself 5 years, after 5 years, there should be some procedure.
Bandwidth, exactly.
Which will mold these lots into maybe new improved lots with different color, different packaging, and different maybe and so on and so forth. Maybe in another 10 years you do another one as well. So you help all these people. And then so not only just marketing. You are doing so many things, you have so many people, and then somebody is just there trying to see how you can change the formula. Even the chemical composition of this product to make it better. That's his job. He is a technical person and a sales leader. This one is trying to see how much are we making. Is it good enough? Or do we need to stand on our toes? Or do we need to meet them? Do we have challenges with the sales? How much are we owing? And so on and so forth. This one is talking about maybe how we can talk to people to make them appreciate the value of this community. What words, what language like, do you need? Exactly. So somebody is there. And somebody is showing us so many people. That's why you have groups and groups and groups. So you cannot do without sets there. If you, for example, for example, it's a group of set, maybe it's a manager, because you cannot have two managers anyway. Maybe it's a group of set. If set was only one person, manager. Then, but under manager, you are going to have subsets down. If you draw, for example, the manager is sitting here, manager, then he's going to have sub-managers. Maybe you call this general manager. Then you have a manager of commercial, manager of finance, manager of finance, manager of human resource. And, but manager of commercial will have sub head of operation, field, promotion, this and this. This one finance will have maybe audit, accounts, so you are going to have, and each one, so you can see this is not a single set, it's the assets now. But then, each person, we're also going to have people. Sales personnel, for example. You are not going to get just one person to go and say, you are my people. You need to have multiples. Multitudes. In fact, per local government, like each local government should have at least maybe this much. And you can now imagine how many local governments you are going to have in that year. If you want to market your E across the area, you get it to see. Maybe the soft or south of the government, how many people will be selling them? That's what you get in this. So, Kotonos, another set. Rava, Goronio, Boarding, that you are only using so that you go to tell it again. So, you are not a multitude of things. And sometimes you may try to take a decision which is going to incorporate on this thing. If you don't have a procedure of capturing them under this, for example, to know what they have in common, that we are talking about intersection. Isn't it? What is the largest set? In other words, we are talking about a set which has all the properties of other subsets. So all these set theoretical questions you need to know them in order to study. Because I'm not going to study one by one. It will take millions of years. You should have a model, a formula, a particular that will assist you, which you can even put in your computer program, which will help you to, within a blink of an eye, bring an effect. For example, you want to launch another product for money. What is even the timing? When do you need to launch it? You are going to sell money, or you are going to sell drink,
actual real time of branching history. Relative to where you want to launch it, these are all set theoretical considerations. You are operating in Sokoto, you want to launch a drink. Obviously, you will not launch a human plastic, because you will say that people don't eat. They eat only in the night, and you don't do advertising in the night. You do it in the daytime. You also may wish to look at the guest appearances, maybe solar applications, or so on, constantly. So there are so many considerations you have to ask a manager. And that's why you require, actually, to have these concepts about sex. I'm sad to say to you because you should know why, in the first place, you need to study sex. In our description of finite simple concept, you can see example, a general manager is responsible because you cannot have two general managers or MD, manager director, in the same company, is it? So it's going to be only one. Yes, so, but then after, between MD, after MD, and after Singleton, you have other types of sex. You can have finite sex, not infinite sex. Finite sex. Let me generalize the finite sex. Or infinite sex. Somebody countable. Some mathematicians don't want to use the word infinite. We call it countable. Now what is finite set then? Finite set. A set which can be put in 1-to-1 correspondence with a subset. So you mark ground line sources and so on, just technical words you need, natural numbers, or counting natural numbers. In other words, we have this subset of natural numbers 1, 2, 3, up to n. This is called subset of natural numbers. This is called subset of natural numbers. This is on one hand, and then on the other hand, you have set A, and you know set A you can also write it as A1, A2, up to A. The way your set is like this, that you can measure it, you can do it 1-to-1 correspond. For example, you can say A1 corresponds to 1, A2 2, something like that. A penny corresponds to it, up to n. You can see 1-to-1. So when you are set penny, you put like this, you say it's finite. Because you know n. Obviously, you know n. It can be 10, 5, 6, so something you actually do. But if it's countable, you don't know. So that's the difference between them. So countable means set that can be put in 1-to-1 fed or natural means. As I was, you know, a set of natural numbers is 1, 2, 3, isn't it? 4, dash dash, no end. This is, we call this set of natural numbers. This is how it is. Now corresponding to set A, which is the set in A1, A2, A3, A4, dash dash dash. If your set is like this, that means you don't know how many elements where to end, then you say it is countable. Or in one. So that's the difference between them. Here it is toss, and here it is not so. Yes. So it is now that you can ask yourself. Of course, you can counter an asset in this basis. Also, we have just discussed the phenomenon of a business organization, which is a conglomerate of an assets. Because at least you know your employees, isn't it? You cannot have a business which will tell you that they don't know how many people that are working within them. So that in all the sets, what they will tell you is they don't know how many managers they have. I think every organization knows how many managers, how many accountants they have, how many senior staff workers they have, how many junior cadres they have, and so on and so on. So this is the economy within the finance. But if we set again, as a business organization, you may also have to have a horizon that was beyond what you are looking at. Yeah, so in that case we are trying to incorporate the sense of infinite finite. Obviously businesses have different maturity stages. They grow from zero level to even those where you are net income will not get you. Also time you break even, isn't it? That means if you put 10,000 there, you get 10,000 there. Also time you start making progress. Then you start growing. So you have some cap like this growing. But maybe after some time you may start growing. Just like product life cycles. Products are also like that, they grow. Star, Maggie Star. Maybe. So you saw, or maybe you say Royal or whatever, or sugar. Normally, when you introduce them, they start growing. After some time, people get fed of them, they start growing. Isn't it? Yes. But good business will not allow a product to behave like this, because what it means is that it will come to a stage where you don't, they're not going to make sales. You won't even make sales. Like for example, now if you say you want to buy what has become so obsolete now. These cigarettes, which they sell in packets, you no longer see them. Isn't it? Or those cigarettes, those cigarettes without filters, they are like outdated. People are no longer, ever if you put them in the market, nobody. Or even if an old television, black and white. It's like you are not going to make any sense, because nobody would buy. Since there are color televisions. After some time, people don't even buy this, says they'll buy the the screen type, isn't it? And so on and so forth. So it means you don't stick the folders and align it to wallets. What is it that you need to do to products to make sure that when they come here, they are launched again, they start going through? Instead of coming down and after this, so you give yourself maybe a period, maybe from 1 to 10 years, you launch another variety. So instead of coming down, it starts going up. Maybe here also from 10 to 20, you are here, you launch another one. If you keep doing this, you are going to be like infinite, because there is no way your product will be an asset. We are always improving. That means the company will stay. The managers will be there. Some will be retired, and I will meet them because the company is still functioning, as well as, and so on and so forth. So it's like you are trying to incorporate the idea of infiniteness. You don't know when you are going to, because here also you are also going to. So you are going to keep much. So that means even the last level, businesses have some sense of infiniteness, depending on the capacity of the management of those organizations. Okay, I think the next thing we should also know is about operations using steps. How do we go through the clean? I think we can have a clean about it. Between sets. For example, the rise of the cash economy in 2008, and also there is another one. What do you call it? Why the economy shrunk, especially of the US and the third world countries? You may wish to study the indicators that made the global economy to shrink. And what are those indicators or variables that made the economy to rise? Like the technological development era of the Europe after colonialization. What made the Europe economy to develop rapidly? Great Britain, the Dutch, the French. After colonialization. I think that, so you may look at those indicators. Of course, it had to do with increased workforce, because they had a lot of workforce, cheap labor in there, because these are slaves, they are just working for free. So the London undergraduate underground was really free, like free because slaves involved as well. So these are all indicators. But then, and also, but then, an important factor that also led to industrial revolution was the competition. Because many companies were competing. France was making profit. Dutch people were busy. Russians, British, US, everybody is trying to compete in products. So, because of this variability of products, people had options of buying, so the volume of purchase was becoming larger and larger. And if you purchase larger, it means the transaction, the liquid cash, because the economy was liquid and there were a lot of cash transactions, and imports and exports. We import our own, we buy our own, we buy it. In comparison to that, there was even trade by barter and some other. But it was still export-import. So the GDPs were rising. And once the GDP rose, the country became more buoyant. They introduced new products. And people had new problems. So there was this rise. How do you compare this economy financial crash of the 2010 or 2020, when there was massive economic meltdown, they call it? Where especially the mortgage industries were zero because people did not have jobs, they could not pay mortgage. And so you have 10,000 about this and not going to be renting any one of them. Because nobody has even a job. So that to be on that investment is now zero. It's not making any profit. Like you have 10 billion worth of investment with no income at all. You have a crash.
What led to that?
And so on and so forth. You take on, you think on causality of what causes those things. Part of it, of course, was automation, the computerization, the information technology, like everyone, the robots, and so on and so forth. Well, you don't need people, you don't need workforce, you don't need accountant, you don't need an engineer. Have new robots that is anyone. You lay off workers. When you lay off workers, they don't have money to rent or to buy houses. So those from global, those international businesses that are having those houses will crash. And so on and so forth. Now look at all those ones. And so if A is meant down, so you are going to list A, all the elements, what causes meltdown. B, industrial revolution. Then you land B, look at what led to industrial revolution. Maybe you may have something in common between this and this. So you may look at the relationship, what led to this, what led to. So you can study so much using this abstraction. And so we have what we call set intersection. Set intersection. Or intersection of set. Two sets, the intersection, let me say, the intersection of two or more sets is a set whose elements are those that are common, So the word common here is important to the individuals in the dual sense. I'll give you an example. If set A is said to be set of even numbers, okay, set of even numbers from 1 to 10, and B is a set which is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and stop here. Then you may discover a set of even number 1 to 10 is going to be like 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10. So if you take A intersection B, you want to pick all those elements that are common. One is here, but there is no one here. Two is here, but there is two here. So I'll write two. Three is here, but there is no three here. Four is here, there is four here. So I'll write four. Five is here, no five here. So these are the only elements that are common related. And that is A intersection is going to be the same for only two elements. You may look at this in this perspective. Okay. So in symbolic form, we say A intersection B, the set of all X such that X belongs to A and set of L elements X, whatever the size that X is in A and X is in B. It is here and it's also here. And you also have union, set union, union of sets. So
you want me to talk about it also?
This one is denotalized. It's human. It's greater like this. So the union to a more set. This is set. Okay. Tools elements.
Associative role,
it.
For example, I am watching you says, I am watching you, I am watching you. A and A is A. A intersection A is A.
This is some of the good laws. The proof is very simple. Proof. It's A and A. So, number one. Let pick an element A in A and A. Then what happened then? X is in A or this is my definition. This is the definition. This implies that X is in A. And this and therefore A union A is contained. Question one. What then? Conversely, let X belongs to A. Then X belongs to A. Or X belongs to A. It's the same anyway. This implies. In any case, this implies X belongs to A union. This implies A is contained. Question 2. So if you combine question 1 and 2, you have that A union A is simply A of that the same. So you can prove those also and the other ones in the same way using these techniques. Or you look at Victoria, you can look at the Venn diagram. You have A. This is your universal scene. Then A and A is simply just E. You are not having any other things than A. Then no matter how many A's you can carry, you can attend those. The same A, so the entries are simply just E.